Let me show you how you can use Power BI to rank items within a group. We will create a ranking chart like this using the DAX RANKX function. And if you are new to my channel, make sure to hit subscribe and click the bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. So this question was asked by Ankit in the Learn Power BI family. And Ankit, when he posted this question, he said that he had been able to create this using an R visual, but he wanted to be able to define that using DAX, and no surprise, because DAX has magical powers, right? DAX measures have magic, and that's the magic of define once, use everywhere. Once you define a DAX measure, no matter if it's really simple one like sum or something really, really complicated, once you define it, you can then slice and dice it and visualize it any which way you want. So let's see how we can do this using DAX. So I recreated a table similar to what Ankit had provided. Now, this one is a very simple data set, but it could easily have been a more robust, more complicated data set, possibly with millions and millions of rows. And what I'm going to show you is still going to work for that data set as well. So here I have a simple data set. Now, matrix is a little bit complicated for me, so I'm going to keep it really, really simple. And I'm going to keep it a simple list. And in fact, I've even filtered it down to a single grouping. So again, Ankit wanted things to be ranked within a specific group. So you can't see the whole thing, but that says assortment. And here you can see that we have the rank 1, 2, 3, and so forth. So that's what we're trying to do. So in here, I'm going to keep it really, really simple and just filter down to assortment. And then I have sorted it by total points as well. And then let's try to write a rank measure. So I'm going to go to modeling, measure, and I'll say rank, and of course we have the rank X measure, and give it the table. We only have one table here, brand rating, and rank it by total points, which is a really simple measure. It's just a sum. In fact, that's the one that's shown right here. So that's our measure, and now let's add it to our column. Now, of course, it didn't work, and that's because rank X, the way it works is it's a filter function. It's an iterator. All X functions are iterator functions. They go row by row. So it's trying to go row by row, calculate total points, and then rank those rows. But when it's operating over here, there's actually only one row available to it. So if you rank the row against itself, it's always going to be row one, right? So that's why it's returning one. So to change that, what we're going to do is we'll say all brand rating. So we're going to clear that filter. So now is running over all those rows. Now, a word of caution here, that I have a very simple data set. You probably would want to separate the brand and grouping it, if you have something like this, in a separate lookup table. So make sure your data kind of looks like this, with the data tables down below and the lookup tables up top. And then that probably shape would be best to use rank X. But for now, this is gonna work. So this kind of works, but notice it says 1, 2, and then skip a few and 7. Well, that's how I do pushups: 1, 2, skip a few, 101. But yeah, so that's not quite what we had in mind. For the assortment one, eventually we wanna be able to lay it out just the way Ankit had in mind and rank it from 1 through 11. So within that group, how can we do that? And of course, we understand what's happening here by simply clearing the grouping filter, and now you can see that the rank is actually not working just on the assortment. It's just a global ranking. Well, that makes sense, because we had said rank all brand ratings, so all rows one by one. So we're going to change that slightly, and let's do another measure here, and I'm going to copy that because I'm lazy, and I'll say rank within group, but we're basically ranking brand. So rank brand within the group. So within that, and here, what we're gonna say is we have our filter for grouping, but we're gonna really use the value. So within that group, we're ranking the brand. So we're gonna pass that column in. So rank each brand against each other. That's what essentially we're trying to say here. So that's our new measure, and let's add it on there. And let's filter down to one of those, and bingo, you can see assortment. It just, you know, so ignore this one. This was our first effort, but now it's ranking it 1 through 11. Let's try layout, and perfect. Same thing here. This is sorted by total points, and you can see that ranking is working within that. Would it work if we spread it out in the matrix format? Of course it would, and I have that laid out over here, and you can see that. Let's try that again. So for each each of these, you have the ranking within that group that all the brands have been ranked based on their total points. And I've added a little bit of conditional formatting to give it some color the way Ankit had initially on his R chart. But again, this is based using a DAX measure, which is magical, with the magic of define once, use everywhere. If you have any other RankX or DAX or Power BI related questions, post them in the comment below or join me live on Talk Power BI Fridays, and I'll see you then. Power on, my friend. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.